Welcome in my video. This video is about event-driven programming in JavaScript. So, how it works, how we can implement this inside our code, and yeah. So, if you like it, or if you learned something new from this one, then please consider giving it a like. And without further ado, let's get on with the presentation that I prepared for this one. So, event-driven programming in JavaScript is basically a way to make our browsers interactive to whatever happened inside the browser. So like for example, the page loads, we can make some API calls to fetch some data. Or when the user scrolls inside the page, we can emit a function to show a pop-up message. Or we can do actually whatever we want inside the event handlers that I will explain in a bit. So the browser ends loading. All right, our JavaScript code continues to run, and it will continue to waiting for an event that will happen inside the browser. So, for example, when someone clicks on a button, then this button will emit an event to our JS code that someone clicked on the button. And if we are listening on this event inside our JS code, then we can handle this event by accessing the event object, and we can also make some other computations with this code. But the main goal is actually that we are listening inside our JS code for each event that will happen inside the browser. And these events, it can be like scrolling the page, or when someone moves with the mouse over the window, or the window loads, or when someone clicks on the button, and so on and so on. So an event object is basically an object that is being passed with the event that happens on the page. For example, if someone click on the button, then this button will emit an event, and also it will pass the event object to our JS code. And so inside the JS code, we can access this object, which holds some properties and some methods. And these properties are like current target and the target, where we can access the target, the element from where the event was fired. We can also access the timestamp property, which will output the time on which the event happened, and so on and so on. There are also some methods on this object that we can access, like prevent default or stop propagation, right? There are also other methods, but they are not used that often as these two. So what are the popular event types basically? So we have like a mouse events, we also have the cable events, and then we have events that happen on the form elements or other HTML elements, right? The mouse events are, for example, someone click on the mouse, then the mouse down. We can specify it each type of the event that we are listening on the window object or an HTML tag or HTML button. So we can access each type of the event that we are listening inside our code, right? Like in this example, we have the input and we have also the button. And so on this input, we can listening to, let's say, a blur or a change, or when someone click on the input, and also for the button, when someone click on the button, or the someone when someone click on the button, then we can also listen to the event that will happen when someone lifts the mouse. So the mouse down and the mouse up will execute accordingly. I would say one after another, right? And so this is basically the main point of the event-driven programming in JavaScript. But I wanted to show you some examples on the browser. So here you can see that I have a form, just basic form, and in this form, I'm inside the script tag. I'm basically accessing the element form, and by the ID of this form, I'm adding an event listener that will listen to each event that will happen when the form is submitted. So here I am specifying the type of the event that we are listening to, which is submit. And as a second argument inside the event listener, I'm passing the function, which I specified here. And so this function does, it is that at the first line, it will prevent the default behavior of the form. So that when I pass something, when I type something and I'm submitting the form, the page won't reload again, right? And here also I'm accessing the value of this element. So I'm accessing the event object that is being passed from this HTML tag. And on this object, I'm accessing the target element. And then I can basically, if there are a lot of difference, if for example, I have like a two input element, then I can also access the second one. So if I put it number one, then I'm accessing the input type of the text on the second line. Right? I hope it's clear to you. So let's say, for example, right, so what I'm doing here is that I'm alerting the message hello and the value. So whatever the value was inside the input, I'm actually alerting it in the browser. So what's wrong? Let's say Piotr, and then we get a message hello Piotr. Right? So the event that happens here was the submit event that happens from the page, from the browser. And our JS code was listening on this event. And so each time this event happened, we get access to the event object. And so further in this function, I'm just preventing this default behavior of this form. Then I'm accessing the value of this form, and I'm outputting this value. So really, really simple. We can also make an event listener on the submit button that we can also make a type of a click event listener that will listen for the event when someone click on the button, right? It doesn't have to be the submit type, but this is really like a basic example of the event listeners. So the second example, here you can see that we have a table with some names and the emails. And the topic that I wanted to talk about in this example is a propagation model into JavaScript. So the, let's say the normal behavior of the JavaScript code is that when someone clicks on the button, then this event will send also the event to the outermost parent element inside the HTML code. Like, for example, if someone clicks on this example, on this element, the event will run, and we also get the events on the outermost elements. So when we have an onclick listener in this element, then we get also an event that will occur on the parent element inside the HTML DOM. It may sound a little bit crazy, but let me explain this. So here I'm accessing the on the document element. I'm accessing all the tags that are classes of email, and then for each element, I'm looping through the each one of them, and then I'm assigning a new event listener that is of the type of click, and as a second argument, I'm passing the event object, and I'm basically making an arrow function. And here you can see that I'm assigning again the inner value of the target where from this event happened. So because the event is coming from this tag element, HTML element, I can access the inside value of this element, right? So here I'm just alerting the email that was accessed from within the element. And here I'm also adding an event listener on the window object. And when someone's click on the window, on the browser window, I'm alerting a message window element clicked. So the normal behavior of the JavaScript events is that when an event occurs, the event public will execute. Right. So here, for example, if I wanted to click on this email to get this event, like when I click on this, I get the first message, which is the email, and the second message, which is the event that occurs on the window element. So this is the bubbling effect, the event bubbling model, right? So this is the way that JavaScript run the events in the as a casual way. But we can stop this by assigning by the event object, we can say stop propagation. And what this method does, it is that it will stop the propagation it will stop the event only on the element from within the event, from the element that the event was fired. So right now, if I say this file, and I'm going back to the browser, and I click on this email, I will not longer have the message from the window object, but I will only get the message from the element email. So we can see, I get the email message, and that's it, right? So no bubbling effect happened here. And again, if I comment this out, save again, I'm clicking on this email, I get the first message, and the second one from the window element, right? So this is the way that we can basically stop this behavior of the event bubbling. There's also the way that JavaScript can handle the events, which is the event capturing. And the event capturing is basically an opposite way from the bubbling effect. So it will run from the parent element to the each child element. All right. And how we can basically run this this way, that is, it is that we can pass a third argument to our event listener of true. And if we do it like this, right, and if we click on the page, yeah, this is basically You can see that I'm clicking on the email, and the first, so basically the first event that happens is the event from the outermost parent HTML tag, our window object of the browser. So when I click on the email, I get first message of the window element, and the second one is the email element. So this is the way that JavaScript runs the events. And again, if you have any ideas for new videos, or if you want to learn something new, then leave it in the comment section and I will make a new video about it. So, all right, thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye.